Hi guys, so in this video I'll show you how are we learning phonics. So we start with the alphabet recognition. So I place the cards and I ask him to pick out the cards as per the sound, followed by a video on the phonics sound so that you know the correct pronunciation of the alphabets are learned by the children. I'll show you how we do it. So this one is really nice. It's by Jack Hartman and it is see it, say it, sign it. Let's have a look at it. And he really loves it.
See it, say it, sign it. The letters of the alphabet. A.
This and then he picks up the card as per the alphabet.
Apple.
So he's still guessing it.
A. Acorn.
Next is C.
So
then he picks it up and he tries to show it to Jack Hartman, thinking that he's his actual teacher.
Car. D. 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 Dog.
So today I've introduced two more alphabets here, that is E and F. So what I do when it's, suppose if it is F's turn, I pick it up and I show it to him. And then I replay it. I do it, say, 2 or 3 times.
B-b-baby. B-b-ball. C.
Pick up C, come on.
C-c.
C. C-c. C-c. Cat. Car.
D.
D, D, come on.
D.
Pick up D.
This is the
letter. Where is D? D. D, D, car. Look for it. See this one. And then he too gets anxious. But this is a part of learning. So this is the reality, guys. They do cry in between. So next, what I do after the video, I pick out these alphabets and then I ask him to match it. So he places it on the flashcard according to the alphabets. What is this? Where will it go? So that's how he does it. Okay, can you put it back on the table? Okay, Athar, can we put it back on the table? Okay, now which alphabet is this? Biba, biba. Try to do it. Does it match here? It doesn't match to this one. Correct, it's biba. Okay, Athar, now can you tell me which alphabet is this? Quickly, tell me the sound. And the alphabet name?
Ka.
Ka. Good job. Now, which alphabet is this? Dida. 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 Okay. Now, can you tell me this is mama C or baby C?
Baby.
Baby C. Okay, pick it up. It's okay. Pick it up. Oh, mama is gonna help you again. Here you go. Put it back. Quickly. That's baby C. Yeah, well done. Now, Athar, what is this? Which alphabet is this? Tell me, it's a baby? A. Okay. So, they do get confused between the B, as in the B and the D's, but then over practice, they're gonna do it. Right now, you know, I'm not emphasizing much on the burrs and the durs, so he's just matching it like this. Okay, Athar, now can you tell me which one is this? Where will it go? That doesn't match there. That doesn't go there, Athar. I think it's B burr. See? Look at it. Look at the difference, Athar. Yeah, so this is D dur. And the other one that you have in your hand is Bieber. Can you put it on the Bieber card? Bieber card. Here you go. Put it here. Very good. Okay, I have introduced new alphabets. That is the E and the F. So I'll give him to match it. Let's see how he does. Athar, can you put this? Can you tell me which one is this? Can you put it on the correct card? Look for the correct card. Well done. Well done, Athar. Okay, now I'm looking for capital E. Here you go. Where will this go? E. That's E. Okay. That is E. Now can you try again? This is F, 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 fish. Yes, well done. Good job. That's upside down. Come on. Put it correctly. Okay. So just to add little spark to this activity, you can introduce these water beads. You create this sensory bin, which is quite an interesting activity for the kids, because you know they like to put their hands inside the sensory bin and take out, you know, look for the alphabet. So in the initial phase, I was using wheat basket as one of the sensory bins, and there I used to hide his toys and he used to take out. So because he's been used to that you know, activity of finding out hidden items, he's able to do this one. So they do, you know, they do try to break these water beads. That's absolutely fine. It's gonna be a messy activity, so you need to ignore that part and let them enjoy this process. So now what I'll do, I'll put all these alphabets inside and he will take it out and he'll place it on the correct alphabet card. So today I've given him this task of hiding all the alphabets. So he's doing that because he gets quite frustrated when he can see the alphabets. He's like, you've not put it correctly, Mama. Place it nicely. Hide them well. That's what he tells me. So the thing is, if you make them the boss of any activity, they like to do it well. Otherwise, you know, you'll see that the child is getting more frustrated. Because when we control them, when they are in a compulsion, they don't like to, you know, they just avoid doing that activity. Make them the boss and then you'll see the difference. So now I have randomly arranged these flashcards here, and he'll pick it out. I'll put the bin here, he'll pick it out, and then he'll match it. Athar, can we start? Yeah? So this is not quite fancy, you know. I've just used one of the Cadbury chocolate box and I placed it. It should have a lid because, you know, then it's easier for us to organize it and keep it for a longer period.
Mama!
Let's do the activity, Athar.
Up,
he wants to eat that chocolate, so that can be a bit, you know, distracting, but let's get back to the activity. What's that? So some days you might feel that your child is not doing it, so then what you do, even you start playing with the child. So once it's gonna be my turn, and then it's gonna be the child's turn, and then, you know, one of those difficult days you'll be able to finish your task. So today is one of those days when he's not willing to do the activity. He just wants to play with the bead. So I took it out and I have placed it correctly. Athar, now it's your turn. Take out one alphabet quickly. Mama is winning. Now, which one did you find? Is it a newer one that I taught you today? Okay, come on, put it on her card. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Where will it go? Where will it go? Does it match to A? No. See? Here you go. Here you go. Kya mila atharv ko? Lekho dekho kya mila atharv ko? Chalo, pick one. Quickly. Ah, you found two? Let's put them back in their house. Quickly. Quickly, Atharv. Jaldi lagao usko. What have you found? It's a F, F, F. Where is F? Where is F, Athar? This is wrong, Athar. This is wrong. Here you go. Okay. So, mommies, actually, this is how it looks like, you know. This is something that you can expect will happen when you do the activities. But just keep doing it. And one day you'll see that your child is able to recognize those set of alphabets. There's one more activity that I would like to show you for alphabet recognition. So in this activity, he has to place these Lego pieces on the respective alphabets. He just needs to fill it up. So this will help the child to, you know, this is one of the reinforcing activity for alphabets. So they are able to picturize it well, and they know this is the, like, it helps in the formation of the alphabet. So some days we just do it with similar colors, as in colored Legos. Some days we use all the rainbow colors. So they place it and then they put it back. Just give them this activity and sit back and watch them. So when we are doing this activity, we do revise the colors, because right now he knows 5 colors. So we try to pick up those colors and we place it. Tummy dukh raha hai? Kya ho gaya aapki tummy mein? Itna. Okay. Now can we do this again, Babu? Are you feeling fine now? Do you want lollipop? Is this tummy ache for lollipop? Okay. So coming back to the activity. So I will have to take a break, guys. So this is just one way of escaping the activity. You know, he makes excuses when he doesn't want to do things. Yellow. Now can you put it on baby bee? Baby bee. Very good. Come on, quickly finish this activity. Fill up the blank spaces, Atharv. Quickly. Chalo, jaldi karo. Baby bee is almost done. So we decided to do it.
Straight line ban gaya
with just red color. Which color do you want to do, Mama Bee?
Lollipop.
So he tries to escape and then I have to get him back. Finish bee and then you get the lollipop. Quickly. Quick. Itne sare lollipop milenge. Which color do you want to do, baby bee? Mama bee. Which color do you want to do, baby mama bee? Babu. Yellow color? Quickly do it with green then. Quickly. Mama also wants to help you. Should I help you? You want to do it all alone? All by yourself? You want mama help? Can I use this color of green also? This is a lighter shade of green. Okay? Lighter shade of green. Quick. B. The bee says b. The bee says b. Every letter has a sound. The bee says b. So keep on singing this song. It, bless you. You know, it helps the child to learn it faster. Are you done with your bees, Atharv? Beep, we need to wind up the activity. So I'm even teaching him that after he finishes one activity, he needs to put them all back. Quickly. Time to wind up. Little baby, put your toys away. It's getting late.
Ma'am, you bolti aapko?
Yes. So this song actually, it's taught in their school. That is what he's trying to say. Okay, so the last activity for alphabet recognition that we do is, we read one of the alphabet books that we have. Just pick, like, I have these 3 books specially for alphabets. So he chooses whichever one he wants to read. So this one has some tracing activity. So he picks it up, he tries to trace it, and I help him with the sound and the name of the alphabet. We do practice beginning sound also, but I feel right now one should focus only on the recognition part and not on the beginning sound. So this is E. E says eh eh, and this is F. F for fish. F for frog. So that's all for today, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. Do like and share this video.